Welcome back to our PFAS Basics series. In this video, we'll cover why PFAS are a health concern. Our next videos will cover actions you can take to protect your health. As mentioned in our last video, the science around PFAS and what we know is changing quickly. This video reflects what we know as of February 2023 and will be updated as we learn more. So, how can PFAS affect your health? There's evidence from animal studies and human studies that some PFAS can harm human health. Nearly all people have PFAS in their blood because of their widespread presence in consumer products, food, water, and the outdoor environment. Communities with PFAS contamination in their drinking water or food often have higher levels in their blood because they have more exposure. Having higher PFAS levels in your body could affect your immune system and make some vaccinations less effective, increase your risk for health issues like kidney cancer, high cholesterol, and lower birth weights for your baby. Exposure to PFAS may also increase your risk for other cancers like testicular cancer, thyroid disease, high blood pressure during pregnancy, and other reproductive issues. Pregnant people, babies in the womb, and children ages 5 and younger may be more vulnerable to health impacts from PFAS exposure. We don't have enough information yet to know what other health factors influence your risk for health impacts from PFAS exposure. In general, though, factors that influence how your body responds to any toxic chemical include your diet, lifestyle and habits, your individual and family medical history, and your overall health. The best way we know to protect yourself and your family is to limit your PFAS exposure. It takes time for PFAS levels to start going down in your body. The sooner you limit your exposure, the sooner your body can start getting rid of the chemicals. Your risk of developing long-term health problems from PFAS is influenced by many different factors and is different for each person. In general, your risk of developing health problems depends on your exposure to PFAS chemicals and your individual vulnerability to specific health problems. Your individual exposure includes how much of the chemicals you were exposed to, how often you were exposed, how long you were exposed for, and which PFAS chemicals you were exposed to. Because PFAS chemicals are in so many different consumer products, you probably won't be able to completely stop your exposure. However, limiting your exposure can help protect your long-term health. There are no medically approved ways to remove PFAS chemicals from your body besides limiting your exposure. Current public health studies look at how PFAS affect people's health on a community level. To understand your individual risk, talk to a doctor, nurse, or staff member at your medical clinic. Our website has resources for health professionals to learn more about PFAS and their health impacts. See the video description for a link to our website and these resources. In our next video, we'll talk about PFAS exposure from drinking water and ways to lower your exposure. For more information, see our website at doh.wa.gov/PFAS.